So that's the gold here, right?
Look at this.
Okay, good morning yet again. We're here in the mountain province of the Philippines. Outside Sagada City, or Sagada Village. And about to visit a little small-scale mine site. Over here, they don't use they don't do the cyanide process, but they do mercury-free mining with free gold. So I figured I'd just show you guys the path here. Absolutely beautiful. We got Leoncio with us, trusty guide and teacher. So that's it. It's early morning. Walking through some rice fields, rice paddies, and some farms. Maybe I'll just keep the camera recording for a little bit. It's so pretty here. It was raining yesterday and most of the night, but fortunately the clouds have cleared, or they're clearing, and it looks like the rain's finished, which is good because these walkways are pretty slippery when they're wet. Okay, I just want to show you something. Over here, because they don't do the cyanide process, they take the tailings all the way to Baguio City. So this is them doing that now. They take it up on this kind of line here. And the boys, here's the boys hauling off the tailings up the hill. This is where we're heading. So what you're seeing over here, all these bags, they're stockpiles of tailings. So, I mean, you got a huge stockpile. And what's crazy is, in Papua New Guinea, they're just throwing the tailings out. And so if they're trucking this all the way to Baguio City, and Baguio City is, you know, it's about a 3-hour journey by car. So if they're trucking it all the way there, clearly this stuff is worth a lot of money. A lot of gold. Okay, so right here we have the tunnel where they're coming out of. We got the mine carts over here. And right beside all the tailings ponds. And the tailings that are being stored.
We need to go down because they are starting to purify their gold.
Oh, okay, fantastic. Okay, so I was just told that below here, we have a project that was sponsored by an NGO, and they introduced a shaker table, but the miners, after using it, they've gone back to their traditional method of the borax process. Because apparently it recovers more gold. So that's one thing I didn't actually know. I thought the shaker table was a superior method. So that's great news for Papua New Guinea. Because in Papua New Guinea, they've started hearing about shaker tables, and they've been asking me to try and acquire some. But if the borax is superior, that means we can skip that entirely. Okay, so we're here in the processing plant. We got someone doing a little bit of panning. And then we have these mats. They actually start over here. So here are those plants for desliming. There's the ball mill up here. Just pass down these two sluice boxes. And here they were very carefully placing the dirt, the sand. And at the very end, the tailings are still kept. They go straight into these bags. So the carpet is made of felt, just like the other ones. Yeah?
It's being washed. All the stuff that was collected from the cloth will be
prepared for... Okay, perfect.
Instead of using a shaking table, they do it that way.
Mm.
They prepare using this than the shaking table.
The shaking table needs technical knowledge. You keep on adjusting.
Okay, right.
While in here, as long as you know how to drive the pan, you can get the gold. So there will be series that we will observe because later on they will do the magneting.
Okay.
We have to remove the magnetite elements so that it will not disturb the smelting.
So that's the gold here, right?
Yeah.
And that's pyrite over there.
That is the difference in Papua New Guinea because their gold is coarse.
Mm. Yeah, that's really, really fine.
And that is the size of gold that they are losing in the Papua New Guinea.
Okay, right.
They are just getting the coarse size while this is being thrown away in the tillings. And they are not collecting the tillings. Irons comes from the rods.
Oh, okay.
Because if the rods gets crushed, then it's no sense.
All right. Is there iron in the ore too?
Yes.
Yeah, as well. Okay, so here's the tailings going in the bags to be shipped off to Baguio City, I guess. So you said this ore goes back into the ball mill?
Yes, it can be regrinded.
The second time? Okay. So this already went one time and then it's going a second time?
Yeah, it's in a series.
Okay.
And then third times or whatever.
Oh, really?
As long as you see something we can recover, then you can do it.
Actual tons. The ball mill gets dumped into this one, which gets divided into these two tanks. Roll it back. Oh yeah, okay. Whoa, he wasn't joking. So the de-slamming process. Okay. So a lot more rods than what they're using in Papua New Guinea. So everything from the felt carpets goes back into these carpets.
Yes.
And everything from here, this pond, goes back to being goes back into the ball mill.
That goes to the tailings pond.
Tailings pond.
Tailings pond outside.
Okay. Okay, so I just came out here to show the tailings pond, but this is interesting. Cart full of ore. Big old pyrite. Lots of pyrite. There's a tunnel. Oh, this is the tailings pond. Okay. Very small.
So this is the difference in Benguet. After the concentrate, get it from the stuff from the upper part and then do it here. Quicker jump.
So here, removing the magnetite.
has to control the air.
Okay.
Because it's like up.
Okay. Right now he's raising the temperature, making sure the bowl doesn't crack. And once it's nice and hot, then he'll put the borax in gold. So the borax glazes the pot, and if it cracks, that way the gold doesn't fall down. Okay. The gold goes in, more borax.
Yes, more and more. We take about 15 minutes.
15.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go. Whoa! Look at this! My goodness. Wow. That's amazing. Wow.
So that's it.
That's it.
One shift.
Okay.
Another shift, another 40. Another shift, so it's 120
for 24 hours. 120 every day. Okay, wow. Wow, that was awesome. All right, so that's it for the day. We saw the entire process, except for them actually mining the ore. Let's see the ball mill, the whole gravitational process, you know, going down in the sluice box, then the sluices, that's their terminology. The sluice box is the big tub where it's de-slimed. and then a whole bunch of panning, and then finally the borax method. So the borax method was amazing. The gold comes out really shiny, nice and solid, so I don't have to worry about losing anything. And so that's it. Just gonna leave right here. A little shot of this other site on top. So the reason this tailings pond or the sedimentation pond is so much larger is just because this site has been operating for much longer. All right, take it easy. See you next time.